Welcome to our video on incidence and prevalence rates. The learning outcomes of this presentation are to 1. Understand the clinical importance of an incident rate, IR, and how to calculate it, and 2. Understand the clinical importance of a prevalence rate, PR, and how to calculate it. Incidence rates are important clinical and epidemiologic surveillance calculations, which quantifies the rate at which a new morbidity or disease occurs across a susceptible population within a given period of time. In general, rate calculations are set up by expressing the number of new cases of a specific disease and placing that number in the numerator, and then dividing that number with the number which expresses the total amount of susceptible persons in a population across a given period of time in the denominator. The resulting answer is then multiplied by a community population amount, usually 10,000, 50,000, or 100,000. The resulting answer can be expressed as either a percentage or a specific amount of individuals per amount of susceptible population. See examples on slide 6. Incidence rate calculations provide clinical and public health professionals with the capacity to anticipate future disease incidents and plan health educational and/or health promotional programming for susceptible communities for that disease. Incidence rate calculations also include a chronological amount of time, 1, 2, 3+ years, to be multiplied by the community size within the denominator of the problem. The example of this type of calculation is on the next slide. This slide details an example of how to calculate an incidence rate in which 450 people were recently diagnosed with the beta strain of the influenza virus within the past year within a susceptible population of 25,000 persons. Note the final answer can be either expressed as a percent or the quantified amount of people per population size. Prevalence rates are also important clinical and epidemiologic surveillance calculations, which quantifies the amount of sickness or morbidity that has occurred across a susceptible population within a given period of time. Prevalence rate calculations are set up by expressing the number of existing cases of a specific disease and placing that number in the numerator, and then dividing that number with the number which expresses the total amount of susceptible persons in a population across a given period of time in the denominator. The resulting answer is then multiplied by a community population amount, usually 10, 50, 100,000. The resulting answer can be expressed as either a percentage or per amount of susceptible population. There are three classifications of prevalence. Point prevalence is the proportion of a population that has the characteristic at a specific point in time, on a specific day or date. Period prevalence is the proportion of a population that has the characteristic at any point during a given time period of interest, for example, within the past 12 months of a calendar year. And finally, lifetime prevalence is the proportion of a population who, at some point in life, have ever had the disease or morbidity. This slide details an example of how to calculate a prevalence rate in which 450 people had been diagnosed with the beta strain of the influenza virus within the past year with a susceptible population of 50,000 persons. Note the final answer can either be expressed as a percent or the quantified amount of people per population size. Incidence and prevalence rates are important clinical and epidemiologic quantifications, which allow clinical and public health professionals to quantify risk or invasiveness of diseases within populations. Specifically, prevalence rates refer to the proportion of persons who have a condition at or during a particular time period, whereas incidence refers to the proportion or rate of persons who develop a condition during a particular period of time.